come talk to me for free poetry, which sounded very creepy, to be honest. Just wait. They're telling me that your network bandwidth is low, so it's not my fault. During college also, all the writings I was doing was for specific people, if you know what I mean. While in college, so I was involved in a lot of extracurricular activities. So even though I graduated from electrical and electronics engineering triply, I'd like to call it everything except engineering, because that's exactly what I did. We were involved in a lot of extracurricular activities in that sense. So after getting out of college, after a lot of jobs, like once my friend Swaminathan, he called me up and he was like, Ramata, ipa enda creative aayittu enda cheyanam? I'm like, okay, that's a question. It's like a wake up call. Okay, let's do something which I haven't done before. Then like one of my friend was like, let's go to Jaipur Literature Festival. I'm like, yeah, let's do that. I haven't gone to Jaipur Literature Festival yet, so let's do that. And that was and he had to back out in the last minute, and so that was my first solo trip. So there I met a girl called Richa. So she had carried her typewriter all the way from Bangalore to Jaipur, and she was a busker from the Bangalore Busking Club, and Bangalore Busking is one of the active communities of busking in the country. I was very intrigued by the whole concept, and I was like, okay, this is a very good impetus for me to push myself and start writing again. I was like, okay, let's do that. I came back from Jaipur, and the first thing I did was get a typewriter of my own. And even typewriter is not a must, but I was like very intrigued with having a typewriter also. So I got a typewriter, and then a few months later I quit my job. But then I thought, I have 1 year with me, why not invest that time in something else as well? And so busking began. So there was this Calicut flea market happening. So my friend who's from Calicut, who's also a performing artist, he's a musician, Ashwin. And a few of my other friends are also putting up a stall in Calicut flea market. I was like, okay, that's the perfect opportunity. I don't have to pay anything. I'll just go and help them with the stall and then busk also if possible. And so that's how it began. And if you're a busker, the location is irrelevant for you. If you are busking, I don't really think that the location does matter. So Kochi has some beautiful parks, and we have busked in the Changamurra Park. We have busked in Subhash Park, also in the Daba Hall Park. For a busker, I don't think the location actually matters. But then for a performing artist, like if you need an enclosed space, there are spaces. And then there are also very good communities that help you harbor those talent also. Like Paper Cup event is one of those communities which I'm very passionate about. So Paper Cup, they are doing great job. And like there are very few communities that understand the pain of an artist who performs, and they invite you with all that respect. That's actually nice. So Kochi is actually improving in that sense, and lot of odd things are happening inside Kochi. Yes. Yeah, so my family still are not clear exactly of what busking is. They see me carrying a typewriter around. I am like, okay, they don't judge me based on that. But yeah, but after a few news articles came out, they had to know. And so I told them bits and pieces of it. I don't really think they still understand what exactly busking is. But then they are supportive. Like my mom is very supportive. With artists have been like immensely supportive. Like every artist who have busked with us, like when an artist passes by, if they are an artist, they always feel like they want to join in and get a bit of an action also. We have had caricature artist who just saw this busking thing, and he was like, okay, I'll draw a caricature for you. And he gave us a caricature also. Like there was this sketch artist who came and did sketch for us. Like they see this happening, they also want to support this in their way. That is brilliant. It's a community that is growing, and there are a lot of way to go actually. You have a idea that like finds you. Then idea finds you when you're an artist, and then you write on that idea that finds you, right?
Yeah.
But for a busking, it's entirely different. The process is entirely different. Like you have a conversation with a person, and that person has something to tell you, which might not be interesting to many, but might be interesting to you. So whatever that interests you from that conversation, you pick up, and then you try to modify it, or you try to work on that. And again, articulate whatever they are feeling. So the constraints involved are multiple. So there is a topic constraint involved, obviously, because you are writing on the topic that they are giving you. Then there is a time constraint, because that person is a stranger. You can't keep them waiting for too long. Then, because I'm using a typewriter, there is a space constraint involved because I have to fit in that exact paper. Like, I always prefer doing it in the first draft itself because then that's even more challenging, right? So that there's a space constraint involved, and then there's a thought constraint involved. Like, when you're using a typewriter, again, you can't delete or edit. Like, you have to completely form that sentence in your head and then put it in, right? So all these constraints are like a creative exercise for me when I'm busking. So that will help me push forward, like, all the skills that I have. I'm just sharpening them using the whole process of busking. There's a very narrow spectrum of age group that is attending the whole event, and like even among them also, it's majorly the social media crowd that is attending it. So there's a huge section of non-social media crowd that are not getting to know of such events. So we need to find a better way to communicate the event or the happenings to that crowd as well, so that their insights into the whole thing can be very interesting as well. So them bringing them into the whole mix is very interesting for everyone. So that is one aspect, and also bringing all the alternative art forms that have not yet been presented in an open mic stage or in a performance stage in Kochi. Like, busking. Busking, public performance of art. That's it. There was this one person, Gigi, his name, if I remember right. So he came to us, and he came all the way from Palakkad just because he knew that busking was happening in Kriti. Gigi wanted a poem also. And I was already busy with someone and already emotionally very much exhausted with that person. And I really did not think like this could happen. So, and Gigi had to leave because he had a bus to catch by 6 or 7. So he had to leave by then. So Nitin drew something for him, and then Gigi left. By 7:30, I see him coming back, and he was like, I cancelled my bus, I have rebooked another bus for 10 o'clock, I need to get this poem. So we had a calligrapher with us, again, Aju. His name is Aju Sheila Gopalan. His Insta handle is Aju Nomoto, and so he's a brilliant calligrapher also. He specializes in Tamil and Malayalam calligraphy. So Aju was also free by that time, and Nitin was also free. So me and Gigi started talking with Aju and Nitin around. And then Gigi told me about the story of this lady called Nallamma, and then he started talking about Nallamma and the story of how Nallamma came all the way from Mysore while she was a little kid, and she's been working in Attapady for all these long, and she always wants to go back to Mysore. And then after that story, so I was able to write something for him which he loved. What Aju was able to do was Aju gave a title called Nallamma in Tamil, and for Aju, he told me like this was a very interesting thing for him because Nallamma could only read Tamil. She was a person who only knew Tamil, and he has been writing Tamil calligraphy for all this long, and this is where his art actually found a purpose in of sorts. Like, a person who can only read Tamil, he's writing her name in such a beautiful way. All of our works combined is going to give someone whom we have never met favorite poet. I always go back to would be William Butler Yeats. So Yeats and Gibran, Khalil Gibran and Yeats, these two people were very formative when I started reading poems and writing poems. So, and in Malayalam, I love Rafiq Ahmed's poetry also. Three Kochi based artists. Singer, I would say I really admire Arjun. I really admire Nitin, not just because he's my friend. I think he's a terrific artist. He has his own style and he has been refining it every day. Forest Child is one of our poets among us. So Forest Child is one of the poets who's also with Busking Kochi. So she's also soon to be the head of operations of the community as well. So Devika, her real name. So she is one of those writers I really admire. I really love to read whatever she writes. Yeah. That would be The Lake Isle of Innisfree by William Butler Yeats. And again, Prophet by Khalil Gibran. I'm very sorry I have to put two poems there, but then, yeah.